Well, 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 what's going on everybody? TH here, and today we're about to sprinkle some pure cinematic goodness into your editing arsenal. You know that feeling when your text doesn't just appear but struts onto the screens with style, leaving your viewers speechless? That's what we're diving into today. So grab your favorite coffee, hit the like button, and let's transform your videos. So this is the clip that we're going to work on, and this is just my friend walking towards his bike. I'm sure you saw the intro, right? So what we need, the first thing is a text. So click on this type tool and let's type in here the word, let's type biker. And in order to modify your text, you can go to the window, go to the workspaces and switch to the graphics. So in here you have options to align your text. You have the options to make it bigger, something like this, to change the font and all other things necessary to manipulate your text and make it fit your composition. So after we're okay with our text, just go to the selection tool and let's place our text somewhere in here. So right now, if we're going to play this back, you will see nothing is happening because there is no masks, and basically we need a mask to mask our text and make it appear as our subject is moving towards his bike. So how we're going to do that? So here is our text, right? If we open this up, there is this free draw Bezier. Let's just use it and let's just go and do something like this. Okay, so, but you're going to ask me like, nothing has happened. And you're right, because we need to invert this. So there's this checkbox, press it, invert. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to animate our mask path. So click on this toggle animation here, and we're going to move our subject towards the text, something like this. And we're going to manipulate those points to match his shape, something like so. I'm not going to be accurate with this because this is just for the tutorial purposes. So let's go a couple of frames forward. Let's take those keyframes. Let's move them forward a bit and let's modify to something like this. Okay. And in order to be accurate when you're moving those points, you can click here and go and zoom in and move like so. And now if I want to do something with those points, I can like be accurate. So something like this. Okay, something like this. Oops, I moved the point. So go like this. Let's go up a bit. So, and you can also press control click and add a point. So something like this, like so. And okay, let's move a couple of frames forward. So we can just zoom out and select all the points. Just click and drag to select all the points. Move them, so something like this, and position them. Okay, so when you're happy, start to move all of these points to match his shape. Okay, something like this. Okay, so something like this should do the trick. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. And you can see that Premiere automatically creating keys for us. And I will just finish this process. But it's not going to be that much accurate. I just want you to show the idea, and rest is just like you're going to do on your own with your own text and own stuff. So I'm going to be quiet and I'm going to finish this up something like this. Let's go a couple of frames forward again. I'm going to pick all the points, move them here. Okay, so and let's view it one more time. So let's go to the fit and let's deselect everything and let's view it. So you can see it's already much better result. So basically after the first pass you can go and refine. So if we're going to take a look at this, we can refine these and you can go a couple of passes. So you can see that we screwed this part here. So what you're going to do is naturally click on your biker, click on your mask path, zoom in something like this, go in like this, and you're going to refine this mask here. I added a point there, it's okay, you can add points at any point. So you can go and do something like this, and you see we screwed there. So we're going to go again on the mask path and we're going to refine this. So basically this is the whole process. As always, it was an absolute pleasure sharing these editing gems with you. Keep creating, keep pushing those boundaries, and until the next time, stay awesome.